Welcome to Her Remarkable History. Remember to support, subscribe. The Life and Death of Jane Seymour, Henry VIII's favourite wife. Jane Seymour had a lot to live up to, being Henry's third wife, but she well and truly met all those expectations that were put against her. Jane gave Henry the son he had been wishing for, the heir to the English throne. Jane Seymour, also known as Jane Seymour, was born sometime between 1504 to 1509 and was the daughter of Sir John Seymour and Marjorie Wentworth. It is thought that Jane was born at Wolf Hall in Wiltshire, but other sources suggest West Bower Manor in Somerset. Jane's family was wealthy, and because she was a descendant of Edward III, and the fact that her family owned more than 100 manors in 19 countries and 5 castles, Jane offered quite a bit being a member of such a prestigious family. Jane was also fifth cousins with King Henry VIII himself, and shared a great-grandmother, Elizabeth Cheney, with both Anne Boleyn and Catherine Howard. However, Jane wasn't that well educated and only knew how to read and write her own name. But that being said, she was proficient in her hobbies such as gardening and needlework and completed household tasks to a high standard. Jane had become a lady-in-waiting to Catherine of Aragon when she would have been around 20 years old. And then, when she was around 26, she became a lady-in-waiting for Anne Boleyn. But it is believed that during the September of the year that Henry and Anne married, that Jane had caught Henry's eye during a visit to the Seymour home. And the following February is when rumours of attraction to Jane began to spread. The time correlates with Anne Boleyn's second miscarriage, and it is thought that Jane, being of a reserved nature and timid personality, is what attracted Henry to her. She was a stark contrast to both Catherine and Anne. Jane was never officially crowned queen, as she never had a coronation, but she did marry Henry just 11 days after the execution of Anne Boleyn on the 30th of May 1536, although she was betrothed to Henry just the day after poor Anne had died. Jane and Henry were married at the Palace of Whitehall in London, in the Queen's Closet by Bishop Gardiner. Rumour has it that although Jane was publicly proclaimed queen on the 4th of June 1536, the reason she was never crowned queen was because Henry was waiting for her to give birth to a son. But this is only a rumour and thus has never been proven. The other story is that Jane was never crowned due to a plague that hit London. But again, we shall never know the whole truth. For their wedding, Henry gifted Jane with 104 manors in 4 countries, as well as a number of forests and hunting chases for her jointure and the income to support her during the marriage. Jane had a well-publicised sympathy for the late Queen Catherine and her daughter Mary, and this showed her to be compassionate and thus made her a popular figure with the common people. Jane was highly praised in life for being gentle and of a peaceful nature. She was even called by John Russell as the gentle a lady as I ever knew, and the pacific by the imperial ambassador Eustace Chapuis for her peacemaking efforts at court. Jane was described in 2 different ways. The first describes her as of middling stature and very pale, and that she was not much of a beauty, but the second described her as being the fairest of all the king's wives. She was also noted to have been a woman of the utmost charm in both character and appearance, being regarded as meek, gentle, simple, and chaste, with a large family making her suitable to have many children. Jane, as a queen, was known to be strict and formal, and she replaced the extravagance of the queen's household that reached its peak during Anne Boleyn's time with strict decorum. Jane appeared to be politically conservative, and only reportedly became involved once. In 1536, she asked Henry VIII to pardon participants of the Pilgrimage of Grace, but her request was denied, and Henry reminded her of the fate her predecessor met when she meddled with his affairs. Jane's motto as queen was bound to obey and serve. Jane formed a close relationship with her stepdaughter Mary. She put forth much effort to restore Mary to court and to the royal succession, behind any children that she might have with Henry. She brought up the issue of Mary's restoration both before and after she became queen. Whilst she was unable to restore Mary to the line of succession, she was able to reconcile her with Henry. Chapuy wrote to Emperor Charles V of her compassion and efforts on behalf of Mary's return to favour. A letter from Mary to her shows Mary's gratitude. Whilst it was she who first pushed for the restoration, Mary and Elizabeth were not reinstated to the succession until Henry's sixth wife, Catherine Parr, convinced him to do so. By the Christmas of 1536, Jane was pregnant, but she unfortunately miscarried the child. And in the January of 1537, she then conceived again. And during her pregnancy, she developed a craving for quail, which Henry ordered from Calais and Flanders. During the summer, Jane took no public engagements and led a relatively quiet life whilst being attended to by royal physicians and the best midwives in the kingdom. It was in the May of 1537 that it was announced that Jane Seymour was pregnant. On October 12th, at 2 o'clock in the morning, she gave birth to a boy, Edward VI, the heir that Henry had waited impatiently for years to be produced. Edward was born at Hampton Court Palace. Jane's labour was difficult, and it lasted 2 days and three nights, possibly because the baby was not well positioned. A fun little fact about the customs of the time is that a mother of a royal prince could not attend a christening, and this is exactly what happened. Young Edward was christened on the 15th of October in an elaborate ceremony, and Jane was not permitted to attend. Instead, she waited in her chamber for the ceremony to be over, and then Edward was returned to her. During the ceremony, both Mary and Elizabeth, the daughters of Henry VIII, were present, and they carried Edward's train. It then became clear, after Edward's christening, that Jane was seriously unwell. Sadly, Jane contracted puerperal fever, and only 9 days after the birth of her son, she died due to the infection that had occurred post-childbirth. There were numerous conflicting reports as to why Queen Jane died, and more recently various speculations have been made. According to King Edward's biographer, Jennifer Loach, her death may have been due to an infection from a retained placenta. According to Alison Weir, she may have succumbed to puerperal fever following a bacterial infection contracted during the birth. But Weir also speculated, after medical consultation, that the cause of her death was a pulmonary embolism. Jane was then buried at Windsor Castle in St George's Chapel and was the only queen consort under Henry VIII's reign to be given a queen's funeral. During her funeral, Jane's stepdaughter Princess Mary acted as chief mourner, and a procession of 29 mourners followed her behind, one for every year of Jane's life. Now, Henry took the death of Jane hard, and he wore black for months after her death, and he waited until 1540 to remarry, although marriage negotiations between Henry and Anne of Cleves technically began soon after Jane's death. Henry put on a lot of weight during his widowhood and became the obese king that we see in portraits today. He also developed diabetes and gout. Did Henry only allow himself to love Jane because she gave him the son he had been dreaming of? Or did the two connect on a deeper level before the birth of the heir that Jane provided? Well, regardless, when Henry passed away years later, he was buried alongside Jane in the same tomb. Henry was also noted to have taken on a love for embroidery after the death of his wife, as she too loved to sew and was reported to have created some beautiful pieces. Jane's legacy is actually an important one. She gave the king an heir, but she also restored the relationship between Henry and Mary that helped the restoration of Mary and Elizabeth to the succession and of their father's affections. Jane's influence also brought about advancement of her own family, and two of her brothers, Thomas and Edward Seymour, used her memory to improve their own fortunes. Thomas Seymour was rumoured to have pursued Elizabeth I, but actually married the Dowager Queen Catherine Parr instead. And Edward Seymour set himself up as Lord Protector and de facto ruler of the kingdom in the reign of young Edward VI, but both eventually fell from power and both were executed. Thank you for watching, and to support, please subscribe to Her Remarkable History. Thank you.